TriniGirlNatural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm doing my fall stash flashback, which is where I talk about all the new products that I tried for this fall. Again, it's a relatively small stash. In fact, I just tried some last night just to add to it because it was so pathetic. But onto the video. I'm just gonna go by brand since I only tried like three brands anywho. Guess I'll start with Bask. You guys already saw my video like last week or a couple weeks ago where I did a demo showing these. I don't have to go into too much detail, but I really like them. Start with the moisturizer. I like that it's light, but still a cream. So, and it's very moisturizing and defining. So it did great for me as a leave-in. So I would definitely repurchase it for that. And give you a quick peek at the ingredients. So this was the first time trying this. In my previous wash and go video with Bask and Bloom, I used the leave-in. This time I used this. I love both results. They both look great. You can kind of look at both demos to compare. But I think I'm going to keep getting this one just because I guess it's probably, for me, more multi-purpose as a leave-in cream, twisting cream, like everything in one. I also tried the stimulating herbal oil. So you guys know I mostly DIY my oil, but I think if you're into buying oils, you should definitely try this. I just like how it feels. Like, it's light, but it's thick in a way, like it hugs you. So if you want an oil that's light but actually gives you that moisture and gives you that little bit of oomph or weight, then try this. I love that it has aloe vera and marshmallow root as well as like essential oils and everything. So moisture, stimulation, growth, as well as shine and oil things. Definitely recommend this one as well. Next, I guess we can talk about sprouted curlies. So I actually got all of their DCs. I feel like if last year or a couple years before, I'm not crazy, I saw other things besides DCs, but when I went on the website this time, I pretty much just saw deep conditioners. So I do have one of all of them, and I do want to do a video just featuring sprouted curlies. I've been so lazy lately, y'all. Like, I've done so many. Like, I've filmed me using a lot of products I just haven't done videos on, like Sorenzo, Caravada, I don't even know what else, but I need to really get more videos out to you guys. I do tend to feel like these like full kind of stash videos tend to get more views. I don't know if you guys are more interested in that. Because if I don't have to get in the shower and edit that whole shower thing, then, you know, I'm doing it for you guys. So, you know, if you just want to hear about the products and you don't really need to see the demo part, then let me know down below for sure. I'm still trying to mix it up and do some demos sometimes and just do some bulk reviews sometimes, some reviews sometimes, other things sometimes. But anyways, focusing. I feel like I want to show you a picture because I have like five of these, but I have the banana cream moisture rich mask. Agave plus agave superfood mask. More. I'm so lazy. I have the coconut water repairing mask. I have the maracuja hydrating mask. And I have the Marula Mint Scalp Care Mask. I've tried three of the five before, and I like them a lot. They do all the deep conditioner things. They make my hair feel moisturized and soft. But I can't really tell you which ones are like more, like they're all nice DCs. Like if you want a DC that's moisturizing, but also on the rich and creamy side. So I guess low porosity approved, but also high porosity approved, you can give these a try. I like that they penetrate my hair, they're not sitters, I do feel like they penetrate instantly. Good slip, good moisture, great scent, like everything about them is great. But they all are pretty similar to me. The first three ingredients and the ones that I tried are like water, aloe BTMS or water, coconut water BTMS, and they all kind of felt pretty much the same on my hair. They all pretty much have a similar texture, which is a nice, light, but solid cream. This one smells a bit like coconut water, the coconut water one. They all penetrate nice. This one has a stronger scent, but it does smell slightly sweet. And I guess I could say the banana one smells like banana, and it has a similar texture as well. So they all have a nice light, but not super light. You know, it's more on the creamy side, but light. Light creamy, creamy light kind of consistency. And they all work well in my hair. So I do want to do a full, like, not even a full, but I do want to show you guys a little bit of a clip when I'm in my hair and stuff. So I want to do its own video, maybe, if I don't get lazy. But suffice to say, if you like slightly richer, creamier deep conditioners, if you want like a 12 ounce deep conditioner, because I saw some people really enjoy that aspect, try it. Hydration, moisture, softness, slip, it's all there. So yeah. So I still haven't tried these two yet, so I'm going to get back to you after trying these two. And the first ingredients on these are a bit different. This one has green tea, which, like, if this was and it feels like it reduces shedding, then I'll definitely be interested in repurchasing this one. Plus, you know, just a little mint and a little excitement for your scalp. So this one has my interest for that. I may try it last. I'm probably going to try this one next. Then yesterday I popped out these because I was like, I'm not going to just show you guys those two things, and I need to show you some more. And I really should have been trying more things because I can't let Black Friday meet me and I haven't used stuff from last Black Friday yet. That would be scandalous. So I pulled these out and I used these two. The Tropical Escape Cleansing Co-Wash from Inahsi. So the co-wash, it's really moisturizing. So if you're looking for like one of those not foaming at all, just moisturizing conditioner type co-washes, then I definitely say give this a try. If you're looking for foaming and cleansing and so on, this wasn't quite up to cleansing level for me. I like my co-washes to be more cleansing, but that's just personal preference, you know? Because some people like really cleansing co-washes, some like balance, which is me, between cleansing and moisture, and some like really moisturizing. So this was more to the moisturizing side, but can't hate on moisture, right? So I do have to say the moisture was great, superlative, and the slip was great. So it just didn't really cleanse my scalp, like reset my scalp, because I was using it under the hair, which probably is my bad as well. But you know, if I'm using it after a while, you know, it didn't quite get my scalp to feel completely reset. I usually don't bother to read the directions, but I noticed that the directions said to just co-wash and then follow up with a leave-in, so that should have been my clue that maybe it was that moisturizing. And then they said shampoo 2 to 4 times a month, like the same your shampoo go. So it's kind of probably my bad that I wanted to use this as a cleansing co-wash. It's more of a moisturizing co-wash, even though it says cleansing co-wash. So anyhow, this line also has shampoos and stuff, so I'm gonna go back and try some of their shampoos. I did get a recommendation from one of my subbies about the shampoos, and the shampoos are really good. I think you're subscribed, right? Pretty Pie Face. Yeah, but I did get a recommendation on the shampoo, so I'm gonna try that next time I see a sale from them. And I guess the star of the show, the aloe hibiscus leave-in, also from Inahsi Naturals. Show you the ingredients. So I did have a super moisturizing wash day, because of course I used this. Then I also used this. Then I used this. So I probably need to try it again, but my first impression was just like it was really great. Moisture was there, slip was there, definition was there. My hair looked so good, like so good. Like I haven't seen that little frizz in a long time. So definitely love this. And I'm definitely gonna be repurchasing it to make sure I love it. But I loved it last night. Okay, I loved it yesterday. So that's it, y'all. That's what I use this fall. I'm definitely gonna have a few things in my winter stash for you guys to peep at again in 3 months' time. Let me know if you guys use any of these products. Let me know if you're curious about product curlies and Inahsi, Bask, you know. Let's talk products down below. Let me know if you're a product junkie. Are you a product junkie? Hey. Hi. Let me know down below, okay? See you in the next one. Bye.